It's a rule clearly spelled out after the DOJ came down hard on the Albuquerque Police Department. The police chief has to give a reason why when he decides not to punish cops who've gotten in trouble. But the chief hasn't been following that rule. News 13's Chris McKee got answers on special assignment.
We made a choice.
From the beginning, Albuquerque police made it clear.
To agree to these significant changes.
They accept the long list of reforms under the DOJ settlement agreement. But City Brass also claimed the process is a shared responsibility.
We need the community's help to foster positive change.
Mayor Richard Berry saying all of Albuquerque needs to help APD change its ways.
So I'm asking our community, please join us in our efforts.
There's two SOPs here to deal with.
Since February 2015, the Police Oversight Board has been doing its part.
To speak on behalf of the community.
The 9-member citizen board works independently from APD.
Yeah, this is just a discussion. It's not a vote.
Reviewing police policy, use of force, and deadly shooting cases, but mostly citizen complaints against officers.
We get to see all the evidence.
Joanne Fine is a Police Oversight Board member.
And there's a real investigation done by investigators on our agency staff. And we have access to all the records, we have access to everything, and we make a fair and impartial judgment about what we find.
And as a part of the DOJ settlement agreement, the feds gave the agency more teeth.
In the past, the chief could just decide and not tell the public anything.
Under the settlement agreement, when the Police Oversight Board submits any disciplinary recommendations against APD officers, the chief is required to consider it.
If he disagrees, the settlement agreement says, quote, the chief must provide a written report to the agency articulating the reasons its recommendations were not followed. That was further spelled out in rules approved by City Council, requiring the chief to respond to the board within 30 days in writing.
How do you read that?
I read that they send us a letter to the board, and that's not happened.
Ed Harness, the director of the board's investigative arm, brought the issue to light in a city council committee meeting last week.
We are not currently getting a direct letter or explanation from the chief.
So far in 2016, the chief has disagreed with the board's findings in at least three cases.
What we get are notes through the command staff and then the ultimate determination by the chief, but there is not a direct communication from the chief to the oversight board as to the chief's rationale for non-concurrence.
Two of those notes came from a deputy chief. The other note was not addressed to anyone. And those notes aren't made public either. They go into the officer's IA file. Fine says that's unacceptable.
The bottom line is, by not writing a letter to us, they're disrespecting the civilians that are in this community trying to get to a better place in the relationship with the police department.
And I can understand her feeling on that.
Councilor Brad Winter helped write the Police Oversight Board ordinance to include the rule calling specifically for the chief to write a response to disciplinary recommendations.
I think that the ordinance speaks for itself. You know, he's the ultimate. He's in charge. And so it's important to really get that letter from the chief to explain why they didn't take it for the transparency.
We wanted the chief to explain why he hasn't been writing letters directly to the POB. And for nearly a week, we've been trying to interview him. The department told us today Chief Eden was too busy. So we took our questions to the mayor.
Well, that needs to happen. Yeah, that needs to happen. There's no question about it. We see the role of the POB as being incredibly important.
The mayor said he didn't know why the chief hasn't responded directly to the oversight board, but said he'd address the issue.
You know, we'll look into it and find out why that one didn't happen, number one, and if it needs to come from chief or if it's been delegated, then he needs to explain that to the POB, and I'm sure he'll be able to do that.
We also questioned the mayor about if he thought it was disrespectful toward the citizen involvement that he's called for.
And here is a community group that's doing that, but not really getting the response from the chief that they should.
Yeah. Well, I think a couple of things. It shouldn't be taken as any sign of a disrespect. I mean, we meet on a regular basis in the administration and talk about these communications.
The mayor chalked up the POB letter issue to a work in progress that can be fixed easily.
I'll make sure that I get with chief and get some answers.
Shortly after we spoke to the mayor, an APD spokeswoman told us today they'll start sending letters to the Police Oversight Board members directly. For the Oversight Board, they hope the chief keeps his promise.
Well, you're not a police officer in a vacuum. You know, you're the police department for this community. And this community has concerns.
On special assignment, Chris McKee, KRQE News 13.